Good morning, students, and welcome to another online life science classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Today I am continuing circulatory system of toad. So let's start the class. So here first we are discussing about auricle. Auricles are two chambered, left and right auricles. It is clearly separated from auricles by coronary sulcus. Heart of frog or toad consists of two additional chambers, sinus venosus on the dorsal surface of heart, two precaval and a post-caval fused to form white chamber called sinus venosus. So you can see the auricle. This is right atrium or right auricle, and this is left atrium or left auricle. You can see it. And sinus venosus, this is sinus venosus. This purple shade color is sinus venosus. Okay. So pre-caval and post-caval fused to form sinus venosus. Okay, hope so you have understood, because in my previous slide already I have given a brief idea on this. Now the next one is ventricle. The heart of the frog or toad has three chambers. One ventricle and two atria or two auricles. Both atria then empty into the single ventricle. Blood from the ventricle thus enters either the pulmonary or body circulation. Because there is only a single ventricle, there is some mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. That also I have mentioned already. Because in case of amphibian's heart, like toad's heart, mixing of blood happens in ventricle, because this is three-chambered heart. Now just watch the diagram properly. Why blue color and pink color has been used? There is a clarification on it actually. Blue color or purple color denoted, that means these portions of heart carries generally deoxygenated blood, and pink color portion generally denoted that it carries oxygenated blood. Now just see, labeling is important. So and this diagram is also very, very important. So this is pulmonary vein. Pulmonary means related to lungs. That means it connects with lungs and heart. So pulmonary vein, this is pulmonary vein. This is left atrium or left auricle. This is sinus venosus and this is the ventricle. Obviously, now this is conus arteriosus, already discussed in previous slide. This is conus arteriosus. Please follow the ledger. This is conus arteriosus. This is the septum. That means it divides actually. That's why this is septum. This is right auricle or right atrium. From here, now see the circulation of blood flow actually. See, it's coming from pulmonary vein and from left and right atrium actually, and then through the ventricle, its oxygenated blood enters into conus arteriosus. Okay, and then it flows to the bodies. See the arrows from here and from there. And from sinus venosus, deoxygenated blood goes to lungs. You can see these blue color arrows. So hope so you have understood. This is a very clean and clear diagram, and some portion of this diagram has been already described in my previous three slides. Now another important topic is artery. What is artery? The blood vessels which carry blood away from the heart to the body are known as arteries. Arteries end in capillaries in the tissues. Arteries carry oxygenated blood excepting pulmonary artery, which carries deoxygenated blood to the lung. So pulmonary artery is the exception which carries deoxygenated blood in place of oxygenated blood. But generally artery carries oxygenated blood. Okay, one more point is that about artery, that artery carries blood away from the heart to the body. And the next one is vein. The blood vessels which carry blood towards the heart from the organ of the body are known as veins. So this point is opposite. This is away from the heart. It carries blood away from the heart, and it carry blood towards the heart from the different organs of the bodies. Generally, veins carry deoxygenated blood, so this point is also opposite. So we easily you can make a difference between artery and veins. Points to be noted. One is the first sentence. Second one is it carries oxygenated blood and it generally carries deoxygenated blood. Except pulmonary vein, which returns oxygenated blood to the heart from the lungs. Veins originate in capillaries. So this is the another difference, third sentence, that is exception. Pulmonary artery is the exception which carries deoxygenated blood, and veins, pulmonary vein is the exception which carries oxygenated blood. Now, veins originate in capillaries. So what are these capillaries? The capillaries at their ends break up into smaller vessels called arterioles, which break up into still smaller vessels which form a network and again join to form venules. This network of tiny blood vessels at the junction of arterioles and venules are called capillaries. You can see this diagram. This diagram, no need to draw, just for your understanding I have given this diagram. This is from your book also. Red color here also, it denotes oxygenated blood, and blue color denotes deoxygenated blood. So easily you can understood, this is obviously artery and these are veins. And see, this portion is called capillaries, and this is actually lungs, because pulmonary vein and pulmonary artery, you can see pulmonary artery carries blue color blood, that means deoxygenated blood, whereas pulmonary vein carries red color blood, that means oxygenated blood. So both are the exception. Now the last thing, but not the least, functions of circulatory system. It circulates oxygen and removes carbon dioxide. Second one, it provides cells with nutrients. Third one, it removes the waste products of metabolism to the excretory organs for disposal. Fourth one, it protects the body against disease and infection. This is actually due to WBC, which presents in blood. And this first point is due to RBC, a red blood cell, which blood, a blood corpuscle which presents in blood. And the last one is clotting stops bleeding after injury. And this thing happens due to platelets. This is also another type of blood corpuscles. So hope so you have understood till this. Today I have completed circulatory system. If you have any problem, jot it down and you can ask me in my live class. Thank you students and have a nice day.